maybe 160 miles, actually 160 miles, being a little bit too deep, but 155, but I thought, you know, this could work for me, because, you know, I normally have all my hard sparring at 160 around that weight, and then I walk around at probably 160, so I think, you know, 155 isn't going to be too bad. If I'm killing myself and making the weight, I'll be strong at the weight and I'll be fit. And, you know, I'll be stronger than normally when I'm at 147, when I have to move that weight to go down to 147. I'm only dehydrating myself, I'm making myself weaker. For this time, I can keep that power, I can keep that explosiveness. It's still been there, but I think the speed is just natural. You know, you either have it or you don't have it. And the speed is still there at 155, I believe. And I've been sparring guys, and they've been saying that they've been, I'm an active fighter. The power is different, the speed is different there. And when you know you got someone like Canelo in front of you, he's gonna hurt you, you're gonna be a little more wiser, you're gonna be smarter, because no, one little mistake can get hurt in this fight, because he's physically bigger than me. Now, I'm expecting someone like Canelo to be, you know, every shot he throws is gonna be thrown by him, he can hurt me. So that's gonna keep me on my toes, it's gonna keep me smart, where I don't want to be getting in exchanges with him. I want to be hitting him, moving it, using my defense the right way. At times I'm going to have to stand there with him, but it's all about making the right moves at the right time.
So if it's an ugly fight, it would be better for you, from your standpoint, as opposed to a fight where the fans are going crazy and you two are standing there in the middle of the ring?
Yeah, I mean, look, if it's an ugly fight, I mean, look, what we basically want to do in this fight is God, how we do it is different. And that's what we really want to do. And if it does become ugly, where, you know, even if I stand there with him and you know, I break him down in that sense as well, I really think that can happen in the fight. Or even if I move, I hit and keep that long, if I keep my distance, a win is a win, regardless how I do it.
How big, in AMIR, is the experience advantage you have on Canelo? What does that mean for May 7th?
In experience-wise?
Yeah, your experience. Do you feel like you have the experience advantage?
I really believe I do have that experience, because being a little bit older and having fought through the amateur rankings and everything as well, all around the world, fighting different styles, and also having that change, going to England and going from training in England and training in America, different gyms in America. I've trained with so many fighters and so many top-class fighters, including Manny Pacquiao, sparring with those guys. And, you know, that is just great experience for me, you know, and I'm going to take all that experience with me into this fight. And you know, this has to be the biggest fight of my career. That's why I'm going to make sure when I go into this fight, I'm going to do everything right, and I'm going to do what I do best.
Being in love.